I'm an anthropologist, and one of the things that anthropology teaches is that every culture has something to say, and each deserves to be heard. Now, many people may not believe that, just as many people may not believe that the people of the Amazon have much to say. But one who does believe it is my good friend Martin von Hildebrand. Martin's also an anthropologist. He's something of a national treasure, I think, in Colombia. And for more than 40 years, he has been doing something that anthropologists always try to do, is to take us beneath the surface of things. And in doing so, he has revealed worlds of wonder, of cosmology and mythology and environmental stewardship in the Amazon that none of us knew existed.
Y ahí comenzó mi historia. En el fondo, lo que hizo fuera de la belleza, fuera de estar con los indígenas, lo maravilloso, fue esa indignación de ver a mi cultura, el mundo de los blancos, comportarse de esa manera, maltratando otra cultura, maltratando a los indígenas. Y ese fue el punto clave que me hizo realmente tomar la decisión de quedarme. Y a medida que me quedaba, las cosas iban saliendo, los resguardos, los avances, los derechos indígenas, en el cual yo participaba directamente, y se veía que cada vez abríamos un espacio mayor para los indígenas, que cada vez tenía más autonomía, que cada vez se le podía construir con ellos y fortalecer su cultura, me fui quedando. Entonces, de 2 años, terminé quedándome 45.
Martin von Hildebrand is one of those rare men who look at the world not as it is, but how it could be, and then find ways to realize that dream. He did it in the 1980s when he set aside areas of land collectively the size of the United Kingdom for the ethnicities of the Northwest Amazon, an achievement that would have been said to have been absolutely impossible until Martin simply did it. And now, the path of the Anaconda is his ultimate dream.